We're off to see a regular client of mine today. She's an elderly lady that lives on her own. I'm going to be fitting a new toilet for her, something a bit more modern. 80% of my clients are women, mostly who live alone. Mrs. Briley, do you want me to put any water in your kettle before I turn the water off? You're okay? Yeah? All right then. I worked alongside just one guy by himself. I was out quoting, invoicing, finding parts and things like that, and I just thought, you know what, I can do this myself. So once I'd worked for him for a year, I decided to take the plunge just before Christmas. And yeah, I started up on my own. Before I started plumbing, I worked two catering jobs. I was young and silly with credit cards, store cards, loans. I was getting tired of catering, wanted to get into a trade, and going then onto an apprentice wage, which was £2.50 an hour at the age of 20, I got into a lot of debt because I couldn't then pay back, you know, my loans, my credit cards and everything. I was getting letters through the post, threatening action and everything. My mum was cleaning my room, found all my letters, got straight on the phone, I need a word with you when you get home, and it's just like, oh God, what have I done wrong now? So I went home, she was in tears, she was just like, what the hell is all this debt? And I said, you know, going into plumbing, I can't afford to pay it. So my stepdad was able to help me out, and then I just paid him back on a monthly basis. And I think it took me probably the best part of 2 years to pay him back. The older you get, it's just, you know, it's time to wise up. You've got responsibilities at the end of the day, and you need to pay your way in life.
There's your receipt there. Okay.
Yeah, brilliant.
So all the water's back on. Yeah. So the job's all done now.
Thanks.
Okay.
She is so quick and efficient. She just comes in, does the job, goes, does a lovely job. And I feel so comfy with her. I liked her the minute I saw her. Women are wonderful at their jobs. They're in business, aren't they?
Bye-bye, Mrs. Briley.
Being self-employed, you don't know what's around the corner. I'll keep an eye on my accounts on a daily basis. I've cut right back on my spending. Most of the time I don't actually get to wear nice clothes because I'm literally always in my work clothes. So it's either this or pajamas around the house. But yeah, if I'm ever in a shop and I see a nice dress or I see a handbag, a nice pair of shoes, it's like, do I really need that? And the answer is no. I've never had plans or dreams to own my own house. Before I met my partner that I'm with now, because we're both in the trade, you know, we don't want £300,000 or £400,000 mortgage over our heads. So what we would like to do is buy a small piece of land and build our own home. I can do the plumbing, he can do the electrics, the whole construction really, down to the plastering. I'd like to think we'd be there in the next 5 years. I try and visit the bank a couple of times a week. It's probably more, you know, safety issue. You know where you're at with your finances and everything. And you, not only that, you don't really want to be walking around with thousands of pounds in your pocket. I think business studies at school should be compulsory rather than an option. Learning to manage money at a younger age, I think, can really help for you in the future. Whether you're going to be running a business or not, it's still going to help you financially.